Hi guys, today I'm going to be talking about two mind-blowing similarities between faith and fear. As we know, faith and fear are two words that do not exist together, even though I do not know if there is a point of equilibrium where they do, but I'm pretty sure that the existence of one tries to stop the existence of the other. So if these two do not exist together, what then are the similarities between them? Number one, what you are afraid of and what you believe are both not yet the reality. Things you are afraid of have not yet come to pass, so also the things you believe. For example, if you want to invest in a business, if you are afraid of the fact that you might be catfish or might make a loss, all those are just imaginations that only exist in your mind. So also if you have faith that the investments will yield profit or your business associates are not scammers, it exists in your mind, it's never the reality, so to say. Number two, both have the ability to bring to reality what it entails. Yes. Even though faith and fear are never the reality like I mentioned earlier, still they both have the ability to come to pass. But that depends on who takes the lead. Most times, fear does because we often make the mistake of thinking the worst rather than thinking the best. We can see an illustration in the Christian Bible in the case of Job where he said, "What he feared the most has happened to him." Here is the trick. When you are afraid of something, it kind of influences your efficiency, which will affect your results. That is why people who lack self-confidence always have results that always tend to further reduce their confidence until they finally meet a psychologist or a pastor who imbibes faith in them that drives away that fear. Same applies to faith. What you believe is what works for you. And to a great extent, I personally believe that the universe works with our belief. The only issue with faith is that without work, it will not come to pass. But in a case where you have worked and you're expecting a result, all you need is faith. Number three, they both have the ability to grow. Fear and faith have the ability to grow if you feed them. If you feed your fear, it grows and conquers you. But when you feed your faith, it grows and makes you a conqueror. So an advice would be to shut your fears and imbibe faith. Even if you do not know how to grow your faith, that's no problem. But don't feed your fears, because when you do, it feeds on you. Thanks for listening, guys. If this was a little helpful, please give us a thumbs up and do not forget to subscribe if you haven't. Bye!